narrative remains suspicious to you in the habits where you don't need pesticides. You can grow your crops exponentially bigger, better, parasite-free, with just agricultural silicone hard sand and stands for produce for farmers. So now that's picking up because we have the results. So the problem is that, you know, the debunkers want to attack the myth with a lot of virtual concepts that makes it tough for the scientists or the pioneer to actually bring forth what needs to be developed. And the good thing is following and the ratings, and I'm over 3,000 products, an average of 5-star ratings. It's a lot of revenue now off that stuff works for people. It is tangible, it can be felt, it can be measured, influencing each other. It would also be preposterous to think that it's all mythological. Also to discount dating texts that are thousands of years old is also preposterous, and it's not going to be debunked because these people do not have enough esoteric, hermetic principle, physics, science to make any claims of anything of what they know that is not true. There is a palm leaf library in Madras, India, that have technical schematics on how to build vimanas. And the monks are pretty adamant about saying, you know, you're not fit to get plants. So anybody or any government approaching them, yeah, you know, show us how does anti-gravity, blah, 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 free energy or energy efficiency magnetically works. And they're not handing out the papers. You have no entrance. You have no rights to enter that. Thank God that the military didn't enforce that. And these monks say that once we find a scientist or a technician that has the spiritual awareness, and I agree with that we will sit down, explain the doctrine for manipulation, and then have him build such a device. But the human race seems not to be ready. And if I see videos of that firsthand, not just YouTube, U-shaped craft being chased by F-16, and they disappear. That is still a violent approach to our visitors, and we are ancestors. The fun part is also that we are God's offspring, whether it's God, Allah, or the ascended masters. The plethora of religious belief systems, you are their offspring. It's enough to name them all. We have 1,775 deities commercially known, 470 religions that say their God is the God, but you have to understand the confusion of belief systems past the fall, from angelic to human race. We are this fragmented mirror. And you look at the Vedic texts here, some look at Hermetic principles here, others look at Egyptian science here. It's like you're looking at a fragmented mirror, you're looking at your reflection, and you're trying to figure out the whole while your reflection is shattered. That makes it very, very, very hard to bring in actually what's relating and pertaining to the body. I have to mention Greg Braden, the God Code, God Elohim within the body, within the Gattaca Code. Dr. Schoenberger has also found out, a German scientist, that the hexagram system of the I Ching has 64 codon-based, pair-based levels that are also translatable in an ASCII code, but also in the digital bit code, which is the human genome. And then you can go into the astrology, reflect with the human design, retract with the I Ching. It's a complex system, but numerically, it can't even be debunked. You have the number code, and then you can see if somebody hasn't developed their CD, which will turn into another video. What's a CD? A CD can be unity. A CD can be peace. It's not all superpowers and Superman. So let's say your shadow is conflict. The middle ground of development of that shadow is the people to get out of their shadow. And that acted out efficiently by saying, oh, okay, because I have relatives, so I'm touched by that. Well, tomorrow, it is the